The Erewash Canal is a 12-mile long broad canal which was built in 1799 to transport coal and other goods between the River Trent and Langley Mill. If you were to take a walk along the Erewash Canal at Ilkeston in Derbyshire, you would be aware of what is now a beautiful and rural site, unlike its previous very busy and industrial history. However, from the mid-19th century it fell into decline until 1968, when restoration work was undertaken to the point where, in the 1980s, it was opened again, this time more for recreational traffic, which is now a common sight all along its length at most times of the year, but that is a topic for a later video. You will also no doubt be very aware of the old Midland Railway, the Erewash Valley Line, which was built between 1844 and 1862, as this is plainly seen running alongside your path. It was this railway which, in the mid-19th century, was responsible for a large decline in the profits of this canal. Through the thunderous noise, powerful and angry, answer the guns. All through the night, relief never comes. Not far from the now decommissioned Bridge Inn at Cotmanhay, a once popular canal side pub which suffered a series of declines throughout the latter half of the 2010s, and only a short walk through the concealing trees, is the Iron Giant of the Erewash Valley. At one time christened the Ilkeston Viaduct, it is more usually referred to as Bennerley Viaduct. Bit of a local celebrity in its own right, this guardian of the Erewash Valley strikes an imposing figure as it straddles the space which joins Nottinghamshire to Derbyshire. At one time this used to carry the Frygate line across the River Erewash between Awsworth in Nottinghamshire and Ilkeston in Derbyshire. The Frygate line was in fact the Great Northern Railway Derbyshire and Staffordshire extension, but the Frygate line was easier to say and to remember, so it kind of stuck. Standing almost derelict for over 50 years, the last train having run across its metals in 1968, it became little more than a local landmark, used occasionally by walkers and local photographers. The area beneath is now a place where dog walkers and motorcyclists make use of what is really a nature reserve and industrial archaeology site, with buzzards being a spectacular and regular feature, along with many rare plants and other more common, although nonetheless awe-inspiring residents. The Great Northern Railway wanted to exploit the very lucrative coal hauling trade, over which the Midland Railway had a stranglehold, and so built the line. They arrived at the valley in May of 1876, and by the following November had completed the viaduct. Services began running along the twin-tracked bridge deck in January of 1878. A hugely impressive structure, it is 1,452 feet long, and the rails, when in place, were 60 feet and 10 inches above the ground. Normally a crossing of this nature would have been built of bricks. In fact, just a few hundred yards away was the now demolished Gilbrook Viaduct, known locally as 40 Bridges, which actually was a brick structure. However, at this point, the ground wasn't stable enough to carry and evenly distribute the weight, due in main to mining activities and subsidence. Lighter weight wrought iron was used instead, as a way of reducing the weight footprint on the area, and a feature of its construction is the use of cotter pins to secure many of the joints. The GNR awarded the building contract to Messrs Benton and Woodywiss, who were also responsible for the Queensbury Tunnel near Halifax in Yorkshire, to a layout and design by the GNR's resident engineer Samuel Abbott and chief civil engineer Richard Johnson, who also designed 40 Bridges, Handyside Bridge and the Frygate Bridge in Derby. As you progressed along its length, you would pass over no less than 16 arches, or more accurately, spans, as they're flat, each one over 76 feet in length and placed on wrought iron latticework columns, which in turn are mounted upon plinths of blue brick, which distribute the weight over the ground. On the west end of the viaduct is the Midland Railway's Erewash Valley Line, which joins Chesterfield in the north with Nottingham in the south, and this is spanned by what is almost an extra bridge attached to the end of the viaduct. More added bridges and an embankment were on the eastern end, although these are long gone, leaving the abandoned Nottingham Canal, which used to pass beneath, now just a series of long pools and lakes, mainly used by fishermen. To the north of the viaduct is a large open space which at one time was Bennerley Ironworks and later became a coal distribution hub. This was joined to both railways by sidings and junctions. Life progressed blissfully uneventfully for the viaduct until the night of January the 31st, 1916, when a passing Zeppelin, the LZ-59, which was looking for Liverpool or Manchester and had got lost in poor weather, dropped seven HE devices, bombs to you and I, on the Midland Line, which created some damage to the Midland Line signal box and the junction below. However, it fortunately missed the viaduct, although some signs of damage can be seen in places. After it was abandoned, it was to be demolished. However, it was so well constructed that it was deemed to be uneconomical to take apart. As such, it survived. It's now Grade 2 star listed, having secured donations by the Heritage Lottery Fund, Historic England, World Monuments Watch, and several others both large and small, and also with the help of the local Friends of Bennerley Viaduct, who give money, time, expertise, and the sweat of their brows to keeping the project alive. There is now a strong movement to restore the viaduct to the point where it can take its place as a useful structure once more. Not only has public will been motivated and permission granted for this, but the preliminary work to achieve this has already begun, with surveys and some remedial work having taken place. Already there are workmen on the bridge deck, access to the deck is temporarily sealed off, and the cherry pickers and the scaffolding bound. She's getting a makeover. The plan is to construct ramps at either end in order to grant access and for the Iron Giant to become a vital part of a walking and cycling trail used as both a recreational and commuting route between the two counties. Bennerley is one of only two remaining iron lattice viaducts in the country, the other being Meldon in Devon, which is now part of a cycle and walking path. Bennerley is by far the larger. It was described as an extraordinary monument and was included in the 2020 World Monuments Watch. Only 25 of these are named throughout the world annually, and only Bennerley in the UK in 2020. Okay, so there are some links to information and sites of interest, which I hope you'll appreciate, and they are going to be stuck in the comments below. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this and found it entertaining and informative. I hope to have some more stuff for you later. Until then, have fun and stay safe.